Hello children, welcome back to English class. Do you know what is an anger? Anger is a normal, healthy emotion, neither good nor bad. Like any emotion, it conveys a message telling you that a situation is upsetting, unjust or threatening. Anger becomes a problem when you express it in a way that harms yourself or others. Okay, do you know what are the benefits to anger control? I'm going to show you a few points. Listen to me. Okay? Yes. Controlling anger will help us to have good relationship. It keeps us calm and in control. It gives back our life and let us move forward. Learning to control anger can limit the emotional damage. So, we should control our anger. Okay? Yes. So, in this session, we are going to see from Unit 2 poem. And the title is A Poison Tree, and the poet of the poem is William Blake. Let's see how the poet handled his anger in this poem. Okay? Yes. A Poison Tree is one of the most famous poems by William Blake, was first published in Blake's 1794 volume Songs of Experience. First, we see the gist of the poem. A Poison Tree is a short and deceptively simple poem about repressing anger and the consequences of doing so. The speaker tells of how they fail to communicate their wrath to their foe and how this continues to grow until it develops into poisonous hatred. First, I'm going to read out the poem, then I'll give you explanation. I was angry with my friend. I told my wrath. My wrath did end. I was angry with my foe. I told it not. My wrath did grow. Here, wrath means anger and foe means enemy. And I watered it in fears, night and morning with my tears. I sunned it with smiles and with soft, deceitful wiles. Here, deceitful means cunning, wiles means tricks. And it grew both day and night, till it bore an apple bright. And my foe beheld it shine, and he knew that it was mine. And into my garden stole, when the night had veiled the pole. In the morning, glad I see, my foe outstretched beneath the tree. Here, veiled means covered. I was angry with my friend. I told my wrath did end. I was angry with my foe. I told it not, my wrath did grow. Here, the speaker of the poem tells us that when he was angry with his friend, he simply told his friend that he was annoyed and that put an end to his bad feeling. But when he was angry with his enemy, he did not share his grievance to his foe. And so the anger grew. And I watered it in fears, night and morning with my tears. And I sunned it with smiles and with soft, delightful wiles. Here, the poet says that he watered it every day and night in fears and tears. These lines mean that the poet failed to give up his anger. It kept growing day and night in his mind because he feared from telling about it and also kept memorizing the ill activity which poet's enemy might have done. The poet is symbolizing his anger as a tree which is growing in his mind. Thus, as a tree grows well in the sunshine, the poet's fake smile also led the tree of anger to grow. The deceitful tricks and plots were helped the anger to grow little by little. All of these things made the tree of poison grow up in his mind. Every day it would get stronger, more poisonous and more difficult to cut. And it grew both day and night till it bore an apple bright. And my foe beheld it shine, and he knew that it was mine. In the third stanza, the poet says that the poisonous tree kept growing day and night until a day when it bore an apple bright. The poet gets deep from here. Bright apple is something which attracts one's eyes and forces him to eat it. However, this bright apple is grown by the harmful nutrients like deceit, hate and tricks. Thus, the bright apple is not good but a symbol of something bad and quite harmful. The poet's enemy saw it shine brightly and he knew well that the apple belonged to the poet. And into my garden stole when the night had veiled the pole. In the morning, glad I see my foe outstretched beneath the tree. In the last stanza, the poet says that the apple bright attracts the attention of the poet's enemy. So, the enemy came secretly into the poet's garden when the night covered the pole. He ate the apple from the poisonous tree. In the next morning, the poet's anger changed into gladness to see his enemy is lying dead under the tree, having eaten the poisoned fruit. Thus the poem ends, and we are learning that we should not nurse our anger towards another person, but to deal with the person who hurt us and work out our issues directly. Otherwise, we become something poisonous that destroys other people. We should be very careful in how we treat our anger. We must know that we should not feed our anger. When there is a misunderstanding, we should talk about it to resolve our differences, and we must forgive and forget. Let's see a few key points for understanding. The poet was angry with his friend. He told him about it and his anger ended. He was also angry with his enemy, but he did not tell it, so his anger grew. He gave more life to anger with his fears and tears. He had bad thoughts behind his smile. His anger grew day and night. It grew like a tree that bore an apple. The enemy saw it was shining. He came secretly into the poet's garden and he ate the apple. In the next morning, the poet's anger changed into gladness. His enemy was dead under the tree. Let's see about the poet. William Blake was an English poet, painter and printmaker. He was born in the year of 1757 and died on 1827. Blake is now considered a seminal figure in the history of English poetry. He was born in London. He was a boldly imaginative rebel in both his thought and his heart. Some of his famous poems are The Lamb and the Tiger. Okay children, hope you enjoyed the poem. Try to do the given assignments as soon as possible and send it to me. Okay, thank you.